So I always read the comments underneath our videos from China, and the one I get the most is, why is Elliot so dashing? Well, you know. But the other comment I get a lot of is, Elliot, it's all good and well filming these Chinese EVs, but when are they gonna come to Europe, the US, wherever? Well, luckily for us in Europe, they're all arriving this year and next. However, for our friends down under in Australia and New Zealand, it's a little bit of a barren desert. But that is until now, when BYD are gonna release the car behind me this year. So say ni hao to the BYD Yuan Plus, good day to the BYD Atto 3, and welcome to Fully Charged.
Looking for some sunshine and clean air? Well, where better than Southern California this September? We're bringing all of the electric vehicles under the sun and an array of clean technologies to America's finest city this fall. Yes, that's right. Fully Charged Live USA, powered by Electrify America, is coming to San Diego. So for fresh perspectives, exhilarating test rides, electrifying live talks, and all of your favorite YouTubers, get your tickets today.
You may have seen Chinese EVs first foray into Europe as being quite big and quite heavy, and you'd be right. They're all bringing over their biggest and heaviest SUVs, BYD included, to Norway. That's what they're starting with. However, BYD's strategy in Australia is going in a slightly different direction. They're going with a much more no-frills, normal car. This Yuan Plus or Atto 3 is what I would definitely call just a normal car. And the great thing is that this doesn't even cost a lot of money either, brand new. So will this be enough to tempt Australian buyers of hybrids and petrol cars into their first electric car? Well, let's find out. Robert rightfully rants in almost breaking news about the unfriendly policies of the Australian government. They're really not trying to get EVs into their market. I mean, in 2020, they sold just 6,900 EVs in the entire country. By 2021, there's 23,000 EVs in the entire country. So it's not a huge market, but that's because there's very little actually available. Now, what BYD are trying to do is crack this market with something which appeals to everyone. And I really do think they're starting off on the right foot. No frills, normal car.
How would I describe this interior? Well, if the outside is plain, I think the designers went on a big bender before designing the inside of the car because it's completely nuts. They have obviously gone back to their drawing boards after a long night of drinking or consuming rice wine and then went absolutely mad. But it's not the worst off for it. With the outside of the car being plain, that's fine. Inside, they've really pulled out all the stops and it's not minimalist. It's very, I don't know what you'd say, funky. I don't like that word, funky. This is quite a funky interior. Now, you come with your standard kind of BYD touches. I've got a small 5-inch screen in front of me. I've got a 12.9-inch screen here, which rotates, which is a nice BYD touch. And it's got some really nice switch gear in here. It's got like a really cool like airline kind of fighter plane kind of lever here, which you push the button in and pull it back to put it into reverse. That's quite exciting. And a lovely little button to start the electric motor, I suppose. Lots and lots of tactile buttons down here, which is brilliant. Well done, BYD. I've got parking assist, I've got traction control, I've got my heating controls, I've got volume. It's all here, so I can just drive, and if I know where they are, it's very easy, and I see it's on screen. That's a really good balance of things on screen and things down here. One downside I would say about the interior is it's quite plasticky. I mean, it has to be at this price. You know, you can't have it all metal and wood and fancy materials. So that would be something I would look to improve for the BYD. But this is a step up from the Dolphin that we reviewed. The seats are much more comfortable, a better material quality in general. One last thing I want to just talk about is the doors. They're, on the Dolphin, we had this really cool like whale tail which looked fantastic, fitting with the kind of fishy theme. This is like this kind of fighter pilot thing, but you kind of twist it back and there's a speaker in the middle of it. Very, very unusual. And I quite like it. It's different. Well done, BYD, for being different. So I just hope this hits the mark with those Australia buyers. Who knows if it will. The thing which I instantly notice in the back of this car is that it's a huge step up for BYD in both terms of quality and space. So from the Dolphin, it's obviously a smaller car, but this is taking it kind of to the next level. And I think they've done a good job. I'm treated to a massive sunlight, perfect for that Australian sun to burn the top of my head, but you can also shut the shade as well. Now, it actually has a lot of leg room. I can even sit at a jaunty angle. I shouldn't be doing that if I'm in as a passenger, but anyway, I can sit in here quite comfortably, very basic. You know, I've got my air conditioning and I've got a couple of chargers down there. Armrest, classic two cup holders. That's about it. That's about all you get in the back of here. As I said, it's a normal, practical kind of economy car. What's important though is that this car comes with a 7-year warranty or 160,000 kilometer warranty. Now that is going to give Australian buyers a lot more confidence in buying into what for them is a relatively new brand. Even in China, they haven't been producing cars for that long, but they're confident with their blade battery that they can introduce kind of that long warranty. So I think Australian buyers, I mean, what are you waiting for? Buy one tomorrow. I'm really lucky. I get to test some of the most advanced features, AI driving, you know, LiDAR, radar, you know, in the world. But with this car, what impresses me the most is just how no-frills it is and how much this should appeal to almost anyone who drives a car, because it's just back to basics. And I think with that, BYD are onto something. What strikes me about this car is how uncomplicated it is, and I think if this was going to be your first EV in Australia or even in China, it's just like stepping into an ICE car, because you'd be used to all of these features. There's nothing especially different about it, whereas I think there's a bit of a myth that a lot of EVs have to be overly complicated or got all these crazy self-driving features that actually you don't really need. If you just want a simple car to get you from A to B, then this small but mighty BYD can definitely do the job and excel at doing that job. So what the Atto 3 is not is a controversial design. It's no Vegemite of a car because it's got to appeal to everyone. It's mass market, hopefully, in Australia, as well as China. But there are some really nice kind of design touches from BYD. So they've included some of the Chinese elements, the logo on the front, for example, these kind of fish grills, maybe linking back to the Dolphin car that we saw a few months ago. Now, what this does pack in is technology in terms of the batteries. Now, BYD developed their own batteries. They have the blade battery in this car and the one that's going to Australia. And it comes in two variants. It's got the standard version, 50 kilowatt hour battery with 320 kilometers of NEDC, WLTP range, and then an extended range version, which is 60 kilowatt hour battery with 420 kilometers of WLTP range. It also comes with two types of chargers. It comes with your type 2 AC charger and a CCS2 DC charger. We have a slightly different system here in China, so I'm not that familiar with those chargers, but they're both tucked into the front fender. So I do think with this quite simplistic car, BYD do have quite a good chance in Australia as well as New Zealand too. So unfortunately, there's no track day or slaloms or 0 to 60 times at all, because what this car is about is practicality, not 0 to 60 times, but it does have a decent one. Now, what you want to know is probably the frunk and the boot size. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a frunk. It's full of electric motors and wires and things, so we don't really want to look in there. But in the boot, we have 440 litres of boot space with the back seats up, and then we have 1,340 litres of boot space with the back seats down. Usually it does come with a false floor, and something I discovered earlier was a BYD microphone. So when I get a little bit tired later, I might go for a little karaoke sing in the front seat, but we might not film that. Anyway, I'll put that back. However, what I do want to talk about, again, no electronics here. You just use your hands, you know, because, well, anyway, you don't need, really don't need it to be electronic. But what I want to talk about is that charging, because BYD cars at the moment are coming with V2L, vehicle to life, I think they call it. And with this Atto 3 and its two charging ports here, you can connect not only to your solar panels, which is important in Australia, because one in four houses or households has solar. And in rural Australia, that's really quite important. So you can charge your car from the sun, a lot of sun in Australia. But what you can also do is if there's a power cut, and I heard, you know, sometimes in Australia, if you're in a rural location, there might be a power cut from bushfires, from, you know, extreme weather conditions, then you can use this to then plug into your fridge or your freezer for at least a few days. You know what? I think BYD have knocked it out of the park yet again. By focusing on things that people really want, like practicality, good value for money, a reasonable car, it's just a normal car, but an EV, I think they're set themselves up for a great success. By not focusing on technology and LiDAR and all of this stuff, which a lot of people aren't actually interested in at the moment, they could have a real sales success on their hand here. And BYD are on a massive roll at the moment. They're selling thousands of EVs and new energy vehicles here in China. And I hope they can replicate some of that success in a new market like Australia and New Zealand. I wish them the best of luck. And I think this should make a big splash in those countries. So that's all we have time for today. I hope you've enjoyed this video from China. It's been a while. I've been in lockdown for 3 months, but I'm finally out again. We have all of our lovely Patreon links, YouTube memberships around this video. And we also have Fully Charged in Australia coming up very, very, very soon. So maybe you can see the BYD Atto 3 there. And if you have been, thank you for watching.